Over the last 3 years, Lane Cove Council has continued to deliver a wide range of projects and services to foster a connected, inclusive and livable Lane Cove. From capital works to concerts, waste reduction to wellbeing, here are some highlights from the past council term. The only park in Australia built over a railway line, Wadangari Park brings to life a vision which started in 2020 to deliver new open space in the heart of St Leonard's. Officially opened in September 2023 and recently winning two New South Wales Park of the Year awards, the visionary Wadangari Park features an adventure-style playground, open space, public art and pedestrian connectivity to buses and the train station. Located in the same precinct, the new St Leonard's Library was delivered free of cost as part of the 88 Christie Street development. With a technology focus, it features state-of-the-art meeting rooms, technology resources such as a 3D printer, children's play and learn space, and an extensive film and sound studio. The library was an instant success with more than 70,000 visits in its first year. We also opened Friedlander Place, another new open space in St Leonard's, hosting exercise and outdoor gym equipment, ping pong table, and a play unit paying homage to the local leaf curl spider. Council has also made important improvements to sports fields with a new pavilion, car park, playground and upgraded drainage at Tantallon Oval, upgraded cricket nets at Kingsford Smith Oval, new LED lighting at Blackman Park and Pottery Green Oval, alongside renovated amenities at Pottery Green Oval. After years of planning, Council turned the sod on Lane Cove Sport and Recreation Centre, which offers a once-in-a-generation opportunity to expand our indoor and outdoor sports capacity. Construction commenced in July 2023 and is on track for completion in late 2025. Work also began on the Bob Campbell Oval Master Plan in April 2024, with completion due mid-2025. There's no more waiting for those residents who have been seeking new skate park facilities in Blackman Park after the popular facility was significantly upgraded earlier this year. But it's not just the new builds we're excited about. Our heritage matters too, with the historic Carisbrook House now boasting a new roof, the rebuilding of a stone chimney and the extensive scullery restoration. With more than 2,000 events held over this council term, our community has embraced signature concerts at the Canopy with programs like Taylor and Her Besties, Matilda screenings, and live music events supporting our nighttime economy. This term, the programs at Synergy Youth Centre continued to expand. We've fostered inclusivity by adopting the new Disability Inclusion Action Plan and drafting our updated strategy for an age-friendly Lane Cove. We celebrated 40 years of ShoreLink, enhance community resilience with Meet the Neighbour events and embrace diversity with Pride and Mardi Gras programs. We expanded our public art program with new sculptures, murals and street libraries. Longaville Road received an important streetscape upgrade with new paving and street furniture to provide flexible outdoor dining. Sustainability remains an integral part of Lane Cove life. We've supported the circular economy through the new toy library and Library of Things. Expanded our solar panel capacity with a 99 kilowatt system at the Civic Centre and a 51 kilowatt system with two Tesla batteries at Council's Works Depot. Improved our doorstep recycling collection service and upgraded six facilities to electric heat pump hot water services. Not only that, we're leading the way with our EV curbside rollout, featuring 9 operational chargers on local streets and 10 more on the way, totaling 40 chargers, including those in Council's off-street car parks. Looking to the future, we've adopted roadmaps to transition the Lane Cove Aquatic Centre to electric heating, offered rebates and grants, and improved sustainability through our development control plan to make new houses more energy efficient. Lane Cove is renowned for its open space and bushland. We've approved the closure of part of Canberra Avenue for parkland, which, when implemented, will add over 4,000 square metres to Newlands Park, creating Council's largest passive open space. We also purchased 14 Gay Street and another property, adding an additional 3,680 square metres to our bushland portfolio. Council has acquired an additional 18,549 square metres of bushland since 2010, and our natural environment has received additional care through a number of grants and activities administered by Council, including Bush Care, Bush Kids, the Backyard Habitat Program, and significant bush regeneration. One of Council's nest boxes even became a home for the first known chicks of powerful owls in New South Wales. We're committed to modernising our services to make it surprisingly simple to do business with Council. Council launched a fresh new mobile-friendly website offering our residents a one-stop shop for the most common Council services. Our new community consultation platform has further improved our community engagement, hosting over 40 important consultations during its first year in action, making it easier for the community to have your say. A newly expanded customer experience team is just one part of our continuing commitment to deliver excellent customer service. Council has made great progress and will continue its journey to create a livable Lane Cove, which recently saw Council, for the second time, awarded first place in New South Wales in the Australian Livability Census. Whether it's been delivering capital projects or supporting grassroots activities which allow the community to thrive, it's been a busy three-year term for Council. We look forward to continuing to work with the community to ensure every resident loves where they live.